three laws which form the basis of classical mechanics to this day. Newton's first law states that a body at rest will remain at rest unless acted upon by external forces. And a moving body will continue to move at the same speed and in the same direction. Newton's second law says that a force acting on a body will give it an acceleration proportional to that force and in the same direction as the force. Put another way, force equals mass times acceleration. His third law relates to action and reaction. If one body exerts a force on another, the latter will impart an equal and opposite force to the former. It is this reactive force that brings the ball to a halt and makes the boat glide back.
In Newton's Principia, there is no mention of Descartes. That is highly surprising, especially when we see that Newton's famous laws of motion are almost identical to Descartes' three laws of nature. Conservation of momentum, force being proportional to acceleration, action/reaction equivalence, although sometimes in a very different guise, they can all be found in the laws of Descartes. Is this plagiarism avant la lettre? Following are the laws of motion as Descartes has formulated them in his Principles of Philosophy. The first law of nature, each and everything, in so far as it can, always continues in the same state, and thus what is once in motion always continues to move. The second law of nature, all motion is in itself rectilinear, and hence any body moving in a circle always tends to move away from the center of the circle which it describes. The third law of nature, if a body collides with another body that is stronger than itself, it loses none of its motion, but if it collides with a weaker body, it loses a quantity of motion equal to that which it imparts to the other body. For comparison, we now look at the laws of motion which Newton published in his Principia 43 years later, and for which he has become so famous. Law I: every body perseveres in its state of rest, or of uniform motion in a right line, unless it is compelled to change that state by forces impressed thereon. Law 2: the alteration of motion is ever proportional to the motive force impressed, and is made in the direction of the right line in which that force is impressed. Law 3: to every action there is always opposed an equal reaction, or the mutual actions of two bodies upon each other are always equal, and directed to contrary parts. The difference between the ways that Descartes and Newton formulate their laws may seem to undermine my accusation of plagiarism, but the difference lies only in Newton's assumption that there is a force working at a distance, which is contrary to Descartes' assumption that only direct collisions can influence other objects. Newton's famous F equals mxa, force equals mass times acceleration, reduces in Descartes' words dispensing with the force concept to the statement that mass times acceleration is constant. This latter statement can be derived from the statement that the total momentum of any physical system is conserved, and that is precisely what Descartes' third law states.